Next friends, today's our topic is geometrical meaning of zeros of a polynomial. So to better understanding of zeros of a polynomial, we have to solve some problems in geometrical wise also. Okay? So to better understanding of this statement, we have to solve two graphs. First one is graphical representation of linear polynomial, and second one is graphical representation of a quadratic polynomial. So first we'll go for linear polynomial. So graphical representation mean by we have to draw a graph for linear polynomial. So already you have learned in 9th class, okay, how to draw a graph for a linear polynomial. So here generally the linear polynomial will be in the form of ax plus b, where a does not is equals to 0. Okay, so here I'm taking one example to better understand it. So p of x is equals to 2x plus 5. Draw a graph for the polynomial p of x is equals to 2x plus 5. Okay, we have to draw a graph for this question. Okay, so for solution, before drawing the graph, okay, before drawing the graph, I want to find the zero of this polynomial. Okay, before going to draw a graph, we have to find the zero of this linear polynomial. Then how to find the zero? Okay, what is the meaning of the zero of the polynomial? If we substitute any value in the place of x, then I should get the whole polynomial value will be equals to zero. Okay, then I can find the zero of the polynomial. So for that, what I am doing, I am assuming that given polynomial. So given polynomial p of x is equals to 2x plus 5. Okay, so here I am assuming that whole polynomial value will be equals to 0. Because if I know the 0, I can substitute here, then I will get the 0 of the polynomial. But I don't know this x value, what I have to substitute. So that's why I am taking it as whole value will be equal to 0. Then from there I can find the x value. So see, so 2x plus 5 is equal to 0. So such type of problems you have solved in 8th class. Linear equations in one variable. Okay, so 2x plus 5 is equal to 0, and we can send the plus 5 to right hand side, it will become minus 5 according to transpose. Plus becomes minus here. Okay, here we have 2 into x is equal to minus 5. So we can send this 2 to the right hand side, x is equals to minus 5 by 2. Why we can divide it by? Because here we have into, according to transpose, into will become divided by. So x is equals to minus 5 by 2. So this is the 0 of the polynomial. Okay, 0 of the given polynomial. If you have any doubt, you can substitute in the place of x. So you will get whole polynomial value will be equals to 0. Okay, so by general procedure, normal procedure, if we solve x value, we will get minus 5 by 2. Okay, this is nothing but 0 of the polynomial. So we can go by graphical method also. Okay, by using the graph, we can find the 0. How? See here. Suppose you can take box here, x value, that's next one, p of x. So p of x is equals to 2x plus 5. So take one box, suppose take some values 0, minus 1, minus 2 and minus 1. Suppose if you substitute 0 here, okay, x is equal to 0 mean by 2 into 0 plus 5, that is equal to 0 plus 5 is equal to 5. So when I am taking the x value as 0, we can take the y value as, we can assume it as here. Why? Why? Because to draw the graph, we need two coordinate axes. First one is x and another one is y. So here I have taken it as x, and another whole value I am assuming it as y coordinate. So when I am substituting the 0 in the place of x, I used to get 5 value. Next, if I substitute in the place of x minus 1, so 2 into minus 1 plus 5. 2 into minus 1, minus 2 plus 5. Minus 2 plus 5, 3. So we can write 3. Next, in the place of x, substitute minus 2. If I substitute x is equal to minus 2, we can sub 2 into minus 2 plus 5 minus 4 plus 5, that is equals to 1. Next, substitute minus 3. X is equal to minus 3. 2 into minus 3 plus 5, that is equals to minus 6 plus 5. So that is equals to minus 1. So like this, you will get coordinates, x coordinate and y coordinates. Now we can draw the graph. So graph means by you will have two coordinate axes. So x origin x dash, y origin y dash. Okay. Next, you just write down the scale. So scale on x axis. We should write the scale on the top right corner. Scale on x axis. 1 centimeter is equals to 1 minute. And then on y axis, 1 centimeter is equals to same 1 minute. Okay. So next, take x value 0, y value 5. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So write like this. Okay. Now identify 0, 5. So x coordinate is 0, y coordinate is 1, 5. So x coordinate is 0 and y coordinate is 1, 5. So here identify like this. Next, x coordinate is 1, -1, y coordinate is 1, 3. So see here, on the x coordinate, on the x axis, we have minus 1 here. So if the minus 1, just observe the number 3. So here we have 3. Okay, so you can write down here 0, 5, here minus 1, 3. Okay, next, x coordinate is minus 2, y coordinate is 1. So on the x axis, where do we have minus 2? Here. And where is the 1? See, right, minus 2, 1. Next, on the x axis minus 3, on the y axis minus 1. So the, on the x axis minus 3 is here, then where is the minus 1? Bottom side. Okay, here we have, so this is the minus 3, minus 1. Now, join all these 4 points by using a scale, not by rough hand, use a scale. Okay. So this is the graph, so you get like this. So this is the graph, name is y is equals to 2x plus 5. If you observe this line, y is equals to 2x plus 5 touching the x axis. So here, so touching the x axis at a certain point, so this is in between minus 2 and minus 3 exactly. Okay, so that is nothing but you get minus 2.5, 0. So what is the x coordinate here? In between the minus 2 and minus 3, that is exactly minus 2.5 you will get. Okay, what you got here? Minus 5, but nothing much. Minus 2.5 only. Okay, so here, so 0 of polynomial p of x, that is equal to 2x plus 5 from the graph. From the graph is equals to minus 5 by 2. Okay, you understand? See, by solving generally also we got the same 0, same answer. By solving graphically also we got the same answer, that is minus 5 by 2 only. Okay, so what is the geometrical meaning of zeros of a polynomial? See, if the graph touches the x axis at one point, it will have only one solution. Okay? If the line touches the x-axis at only one point, it will have only 1, 0. Okay. So generally, linear polynomial degree is 1. So that's why you will get the zeros are only 1. Till now, we have learned the graphical representation of a linear polynomial. So what we have understood, if the line touches the x-axis at one point, we will have maximum 1, 0. Okay. Graphically also, we got the same answer. By general procedure also, we got the same answer. Okay, we see here, we are representing graphically quadratic polynomial. okay, graphical representation of quadratic polynomial here. Suppose quadratic polynomial will be in the form of a p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, where a does not is equal to 0. Okay, so for a linear polynomial, if you draw a graph, you will get straight line. Already you have it in 9th class. But here we are going to learn, in the 10th class, we are going to learn quadratic polynomials, how to draw a graph. Okay, if you draw a graph for quadratic polynomial, you will get a parabolic shape. Parabolic shape. The graph will be parabolic shape. Okay, here if a is greater than 0, you will get like this. Okay, so this is known as upward parabola. If a is less than 0, okay, if the x square coefficient a is less than 0 means by negative, okay, you will get the parabolic shape like this. Okay, so in downward parabola. So downward parabola or inverted parabola. Okay, if p of x is equal to ax square plus bx plus c, this is a quadratic polynomial general formula where a does not is equal to 0. If you want to draw a graph for quadratic polynomial, you will get the shape is parabolic shape. Okay, so if a coefficient of x square a is greater than 0, nothing but positive value, you will get the graph like this. So this shape is known as upward parabola. Okay, if a is less than 0, nothing but negative value, if the a is in negative, you will get the graph like this. Okay, so this shape is known as downward parabola. Okay, so for example, here we will solve one problem. Okay, for example, so I am taking, so p of x is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2. Draw a graph for this polynomial p of x is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2 and obtain the zeros from the graph. Obtain the zeros from the graph. This is the question. Okay? And solution. Okay? So solution is what? I am solving generally. Already you have learned in 9th class how to splitting the middle term. How to factorize the given polynomial. Already we have learned in 9th class. So let me solve here. So p of x is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2. Okay. So here we have to find the zeros. So to find the zeros, whole polynomial value will be equal to 0. Already we know that. X square minus 3x plus 2 is equal to 0. I am writing. Okay. So here we have to split the middle term, this term. Okay, so what is the coefficient of x square? Nothing is here. We can write it as 1. Okay, so let's multiply coefficient of x square. What is the coefficient of x square? 1 into, we have to multiply constant term. What is the constant term? 2. So 1 goes on 2. Write the factors for 2. Factors mean by in which table you will get the 2 number. That is 1 and 2 only. Yes sir. Okay, 1 and 2. By adding or by subtracting, you should get the middle term. Okay, 2 minus 1, 1. But here we have 3. It's not possible. 2 plus 1. So how much is 3? Okay, by adding or by subtracting, any one of the operation you should apply. Okay, if I subtract, you will not get 3. If I add these two numbers, I will get the middle term, that is 3. Okay, but the middle term is negative, no? So apply negative sign for both the numbers. Okay, so here I am writing x square minus 1x minus 2x plus 2 is equals to 0. See here, minus 1 minus 2, how much? Minus 3. If you multiply both, minus 1 into minus 2, you will get plus 2. Okay, both the conditions will be satisfied. So from the first two terms, what we can take common? X. So x into x minus 1. Okay. From the first two terms, I can take common x. X into x minus 1. And from the last two terms, I can take a minus 2 common. Okay. And write the same thing here. ओके माइनस टू इंटू एक्स माइनस टू एक्स माइनस इंटू माइनस प्लस टू इंटू वन टू ओके सो द अगेन वी हैव कॉमन x माइनस 1 एंड x माइनस 1 एंड इट इज द कॉमन x माइनस 1 इनटू x माइनस 2 इज इक्वल टू 0 सो नाउ 0 विल बी एप्लीकेबल फॉर एनी वन ऑफ दिस टू केसेस सो आई कैन राइट दिस एज x माइनस 1 इज इक्वल टू 0 और x माइनस 2 इज इक्वल टू 0 सो सेंड दिस माइनस 1 टू राइट हैंड साइड इट विल बिकम प्लस 1 सो सेंड दिस माइनस 2 टू राइट हैंड साइड इट विल बिकम प्लस 2 So what are the values for x 1 and 2? So here these 1 and 2 are zeros of given polynomial. So here 1 and 2 both are known as zeros of a given polynomial. This is by general solving method. Okay? So we'll see graphically also. To draw a graph, you need two coordinate axes. So first one is one x coordinate axis, next y coordinate axis. So x value will be x only, then y value I am assuming as p of x. Okay, x square minus 3 of x plus 2. So draw a box. For example, I am taking random values. You can take your own values. Not only these four values, you can take anything. Okay, no problem. So y is equal to x square minus 3x plus 2. First, you substitute in the place of x 0. Okay, if I take x is equal to 0, so 0 square minus 3 into 0 plus 2. 0 square mean by 0. 3 into 0 0. So 0 minus 0 plus 2. 0 minus 0, 0. 0 plus 2, 2. Okay, y value will be 2. Next, substitute 1. If I substitute x is equal to 1, 1 square minus 3 into 1 plus 2. 1 square mean by 1, 3 into 1, 3 plus 2. 1, 2, first add positive terms. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 minus 3, 0. So you get 0 here. Next, substitute 2, 1. X is equal to 2 mean by 2 square minus 3 into 2 plus 2. 2 square mean by how much? 2 2 is 4 minus 3 2 is 6 plus 2. 4 plus 2. First add the positive terms. 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. 6 minus 6 is 0. Okay, again here also you got the 0. Now you substitute 3. X is equal to 3. 3 square minus 3 into 3 plus 2. 3 square mean by 9. Okay, minus 3 into 3, 9 plus 2. Now plus 10 minus 3 will be cancelled. Here we left with 2. Okay, so we can take many number of values, but here I am taking only 4. You can take any 4, not only these 4. Okay, next, draw the graph. So draw the graph. Okay. So next to write the scale on x axis 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit you can take on y axis 1 centimeter is equal to 1 unit so this is x origin x dash y origin y dash now you write the numbers 1 2 3 4, 5, next 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. See here all the values are positive only, so that's why I'm taking these two ones. No need to write the negative values. Okay? So first one, x coordinate is 1, 0. Next, y coordinate is 1, 2. When the x coordinate is 2, y coordinate will be 2. Okay? Next, when the x coordinate is 1, y coordinate is 0, then where you keep here? Okay? See, first to go for x coordinate, that is 1. And where will be the 0 in the y axis? Not there. So, right? Here is it. Okay. Next, x coordinate is 1, 2. Then where is the 0 on the y axis? Not there. So, just write here itself. Okay. Next, x coordinate is 1, 3. And what is the y coordinate? 2. सोलह एटी है. ओके नाउ जॉइन देम बाय फ्री हैंड और रफ हैंड, डोंट यूज के. ओके जॉइन दिस फोर पॉइंट्स बाय फ्री हैंड. ओके जॉइन दिस फोर पॉइंट्स बाय फ्री हैंड, यू कैन एक्सटेंड अप टू एनी वे, नो प्रॉब्लम. ओके लाइक दिस इज द ग्राफ, पैराबोलिक शेप. अपवर्ड पैराबोला, डाउनवर्ड पैराबोला, अपवर्ड पैराबोला, अपवर्ड पैराबोला. सो हियर इज इट ए वैल्यू इज ग्रेटर देन 0 और लेस देन 0, सो नथिंग इज देन बाय 1 ओनली. सो ये 1 मींस बाय पॉजिटिव वैल्यू. सो व्हेन द ए इज ग्रेटर देन 0 यू विल गेट अपवर्ड पैराबोला. एंड वन मोर थिंग यू हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड, this graph is touching the x-axis at two different points. Okay, this parabolic graph is touching the x-axis at two different points. So what is this graph we are drawing? For quadratic polynomial, what is the degree of quadratic polynomial? 2. So at most maximum how many zeros does it contain? 2. Okay, so that's why the graph also touches the x-axis at two different places. Okay, and again one more thing you have to observe, by solving general method we got the zeros are 1 and 2. Graphically also you got the same answer 1 and 2. Okay, so touching the x axis at two different points.
Next
one got so where at when the x coordinate is 1, y coordinate is 0, and when the x coordinate is 2, y coordinate is 0. So by solving graphically you will get the same answer. You, if you solve by general method also you will get the same answer. So then coming to our heading, geometrical meaning of zeros of a polynomial. What is the geometrical meaning here? If the graph touches the x axis at two different points, it will have two different solutions for a quadratic polynomial. In the previous case, we have learned for linear polynomial only. In that case, the graph, the line touches the x-axis at only one point. So that is the geometrical meaning. If the degree is 1, 0 will be 1, it will touch the x-axis at only one point. If the quadratic polynomial degree is 2, it will touch the x-axis at two different points, it will have two zero solutions. Okay, if you go for cubic polynomial, okay, the degree is 3, it will touch the x-axis at three different points and it will have three zeros, three solutions. Okay, and one more thing here, so this is the geometrical meaning of zeros of a polynomial. So one more thing, we have some information. See here, we have three cases. Case 1. So in the case 1, if A is, so the graph will be like this. So here in the case 1, you will get two distinct and different points. Okay. So this is the 1 more 0 and this is 1 more 0 and here 1 more 0 and 1 more 0. Okay. So the graph you may get like this. Okay. Next one, case 2. So sometimes you get the graph like it touches the x-axis is only one point or otherwise like this. Okay, next case 3. So graph does not touches the x-axis. Okay, so in the first case graph may touch the x-axis at two different points. So the example is just now we have solved. Okay, so for case 2 the graph same parabolic shape only, but it touches the x-axis at only one point. So here some of you will get one doubt. So if the degree is 2 mean by, you have to get the two zeros na sir, it should touches the x-axis at two points na sir, then why it is touching at one point? See, means it will touch the x-axis at only one point, but you will get two zeros. For example, if you solve x square minus 6x plus 9 or x square minus 4x plus 4, solve these two problems, you will get two repeated zeros, same numbers. Here 3, 3, here 2, 2. Okay, so here in the case 3, so the parabolic curve does not touching the x-axis, it's not intersecting the x-axis. So that means by you will get no zeros, no real zeros. You will get imaginary, but you won't get real rows. For example, you can take x square plus 4x plus 5. Just try to factorize this polynomial. You won't get any real numbers. You won't get answer. Okay? So you will get the solutions are zeros in the form of imaginary numbers. Okay? So that's what we have learned today. So once again I am repeating the statement. So what we have learned? Geometrical meaning of zeros of a polynomial. Okay? If the polynomial is a linear, it will have a degree 1. It will have the 0, 1. And it touches the x-axis at only one point. Next, coming to quadratic polynomial, the degree is 2, the maximum solutions are 2, and it will touches the x-axis at 2 different points. Okay? Then cubic polynomial, degree is 3, it will have the solutions 3, and it touches the x-axis at 3 different points. Okay? So, read well, practice at home. Okay? Thank you.